In this episode, we get to take a closer look of the alpha male. He is full of wise knowledge and stories, so buckle up and sit down and enjoy Paul Taranto.
You'll notice the eucalypt trees. We have a whole parade of them here, both sides of the road. They're all from Australia.
There's one. There's one. There's another one. No, Tim.
I think it would have taken more than
you say it.
It would have taken a couple of months.
Something back in the day took a few weeks to get here, and it took us 24 hours.
No, Nuno Lanasa came out as a 10-year-old boy.
How do you spell?
He taught himself how to speak English.
Okay, I have to teach myself how to speak Italian.
He hung out at the line. Self-educated man.
We got palm trees. They're from Queensland. I'm not taking the piss, I'm putting this into a movie. Yeah.
An American citizen up until the late 1960s, early 1970s. And she played a big part in the Australian American Friendship Association.
She was born in Boston. I'll show you a video.
Sorry?
So he plays professional.
Well, she left
Boston because her mother was dying. So she came back to the island. And then she met Mama, who was a lot older, not rugby. Australian, well, it's pretty much old.
Gold digger?
It's a little bit different. You know, Gaelic.
He was
my.
He was 10 years old.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll show you a picture. Anyway, and then they got married when she was quite young. They came out.
So, coming out of the Second World War, the Australian government put in place rent controls.
Yeah.
Which meant that rents could not be increased. So that meant landlords didn't feel inclined to fix things and do things up.
It's a very American thing.
Anyway, so there was this lady, we called her Auntie Vera, a nice lady, and she lived at 51 Ross Street. One of these rent controlled houses.
Yeah.
So very little work was done on it. Anyway, the time came for Auntie Vera to move on to other things. But Nonna then offered me the house.
Well, just to rent.
For me and my uni mates.
No.
So we lived in it for 2 years, and I am pleased to say that everyone who lived there obtained high distinctions. Academically, we were brilliant. We had one rule. That rule was all work had to be finished before the grog could be consumed. So we would usually finish rewriting our lecture notes and stuff at 10:30 at night. Then we would open the bottles of Vic and Foster's and so forth. Many a great discussion was held at that dwelling. There was some great artwork. One of those people has now gone on to become a history of professor at Yale University. Another one has become a leading activist in Aboriginal housing in Western Australia. And one of them's a boring chemical engineer.
We now come to the final story of this episode. Here is where the Taranto family came from. How's the serenity?
Alright, Dad, tell us where we are.
So here we are in Val di Chiesa, Valley of the Church, between Montfore and Montferrici.
Yeah?
Up here we have the Church of the Madonna.